Please welcome Ellen Page, everybody. Ellen Page.
This movie looks fantastic. I mean, really fantastic.
I'm pretty excited about it. I'm pretty humbled and thrilled to be involved.
Do you think, though, how did you get here?
Often, of course.
No, here, to the show.
Oh, right in this moment.
Yeah, exactly, because... Ha-ha! Oh, sorry.
I don't know. What is that?
Somebody made this. I think it's meant to be me. And they sent it in because apparently I need to wear a mask of me.
You fell asleep outside in the Caribbean or something.
Yeah, it's how other people see me. So
it's
clearly,
they really match your Scottish skin quite well.
If I was from the Pakistan area of Scotland,
it's quite.
Have you ever been to Scotland?
No, but I live in Nova Scotia, which is Latin
New Scotland. Yeah, that's right. Really, you still live there?
Yeah, I mean, I live here, and I spend a lot of time here, but I also live there.
I see. Do you have your own jet airplane or something?
I don't, no.
Right, okay. Nova Scotia is very nice, isn't it? It's very beautiful.
It's gorgeous.
Do you do a lot of walking up and down with knitwear on?
Knitwear?
Knitwear, you know,
knitwear.
Woolen outfits.
Oh, in the winter, yeah, I really like sweaters. Is this weird? I get excited about winter because I like beautiful sweaters.
I do too. I like to wear hoodies, but if I wear them in the summer, people think, take the hoodie off, Grandpa, and B, I faint from the heat.
Right. But... Yeah, people always comment that I wear too much, like in the summer, heat wise or what have you.
Right.
And I do.
It's very hot in LA today.
Yeah.
Yeah. That would probably bother you with your fair Canadian skin.
It heats a little much for me. I'm not gonna lie to you on that one.
Well, what? Why are you gonna lie to me on that? All right. I'll ask you three questions, right?
Okay.
And you tell me the truth on two of them, and one of them's a lie, and I have to guess which one.
Perfect.
All right? All right, then. Do you have a boyfriend?
No.
Do you enjoy the work of Justin Timberlake?
Yes.
Is Justin Timberlake your boyfriend?
Yes.
That doesn't make any sense.
No, it doesn't.
So, that's good, though. That'll hit the internet pretty hard.
Yeah. That's what she said.
Hey! Look at you with your late night thing going on. You should do one of these shows.
I should host one?
Yeah. Do Nova Scotia Tonight.
On CBC in Canada.
And I've been to Canada, you know. I enjoy the ham, which is, you know, you call bacon, of course.
Yeah. Okay.
And the William Shatner.
Pamela Anderson.
Also from Canada, yeah. People often mistake you and Pamela Anderson, don't they?
It's funny, it's just because, you know.
The Canadian thing.
That or the boobs.
One of those is a lie, isn't it? Now, what do you do up there in Nova Scotia? Because obviously, clearly that's where you go when you're not working, right? Do you go sailing, or do you, plow for crops?
Weirdly enough, I have, worked on farms.
I wasn't being facetious.
Yeah, okay. No, I don't go. Boats kind of freak me out.
Why?
I don't know. I grew up next to the ocean, and I love it, and I love, kind of almost have to be near it. It's one of those things, but it's huge and amazing and kind of scares me a little bit. I feel like rightfully so. What? What do? I do all kinds of things. I have dogs, so I love hiking.
How many dogs?
Two rescues.
Really? What do you have?
I have an old beagle rescue named Julie, also known as Juby Dooby.
That's adorable. Yeah.
And I have another little rescue from here, from a big shelter, the North Central Shelter in LA. It's just like a little, not, you know, tons of different dogs, terrier
mix,
named Sprout.
Well, that's rather nice. And do you transport the dogs between two places, or do you have a dog for LA and a dog for Nova Scotia?
Yeah, I'd like to have a dog in every time zone.
Right, no, no. It's hard to move dogs around, because I like to go to the East Coast to go to Vermont, and I have three dogs, and it's very difficult.
Yeah, I leave them in Nova Scotia, and, you know, like, one of my best friends in the whole world looks after them when I'm away, and they've become almost just as much her dogs as mine, and, you know, the reason I don't bring them here is just...
In case they get into show business.
Yeah, I worry about the drugs.
Yeah. Yeah, because the drugs in LA are crap.
They're always laced with something.
Yeah.
They
stay in Nova Scotia and frolic.
They love it there, and if I feel kind of selfish bringing them, and no, that's nothing to be said to people who transport their dogs, but I feel I tried it. And they just acted differently.
Are your dogs farty? I have a dog that's particularly farty. It's French bulldog.
Those are farty.
They are farty.
Yeah, those are farty.
And they very small, kind of a rescue dog. And she has 9 nipples and a hernia.
Wow.
Yeah.
Julie.
It's sexy time.
I'm sorry, that made me laugh, actually.
Julie, the beagle. Also known as Juby Dooby, was bred, overbred. She was used as a hunting dog, which is fine, but they also really abused her. And if I ever find you...
Who are we
I have no idea.
All right,
She has a nipple that's like been punctured, and it dangles really low.
Okay.
And it really, really grosses people out, and they're always like, ew, ew. And I'm always like, you have a spare tire you could lose, so.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, don't insult my dog.
That's not the way to go there, Ellen. No, you want to just go,
Oh, I'm a jerk, though.
No, you're not. No, are you really?
Total.
Tootsie fruitsy. Suffer fruit.
Am I on TV?
No. Into a terrible trouble for cussing here. They beat me, and they put flags in front of my mouth. It's terrible.
Yeah.
Do you cuss a lot in your own life?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Probably more than people would think because of this face.
I ain't buying that for a second, sister. No, I think that cute people cuss more to try and cover up how adorable they are.
Again, Nova Scotia's Latin for New Scotland.
So, right.
Yeah.
These Scottish people cuss a lot.
That's what I'm just assuming.
Oh, no, we do.
Yeah, yeah.
The thing is, though, that because the accent is almost indecipherable to anyone who's outside of there, people are like, oh, that's adorable, thank you. Yeah.
Yes,
the accent in Nova Scotia, is there a very strong accent there?
Well, there's accents in, like, different places, I guess. So, it's funny, I'm not, like... Okay, for example, like where my dad's from in the South Shore, they have a very distinct accent, and I love it. He had a friend who, when he was a kid, was speeding, and speeding as in driving, and the police came up, and he just looked at them, and he went, "Damn accelerator, got stuck to the floor again."
I have no idea what you said.
I don't know.
Yeah, no, that's nice.
So you should come hang out, because maybe...
In Nova Scotia? I think I'd like it in Nova Scotia.
Well, if you ever want to come.
It got weird, didn't it?
It did. Yeah.
I thought it was going good.
I did too.
We were getting along.
I just ruined it all.
No, you didn't ruin it. It just kind of got a little weird. We'll get past it.
I like your snake mug.
Thanks very much. It's it's a substitute for a small penis. It's actually not. It's a double bluff. I've got a huge penis.
That's
mouth organ. I've used it though.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's what she said.
Do you want to look soulfully into the camera and I'll play the mouth organ?
Yeah, which is the camera? Is this
the one with the light on?
Okay.
The camera.
Okay.
All right, you look in there and like do something soulful and like independent movie-ish, and I'll.
Do I stay here and I just?
Yeah, whatever you want. Okay. Oh, I just banged my knee there. Okay. All right, you ready? Too much. You're doing too much. You're doing too much. Yeah, it's too much.
Pull back.
Guest is in a new film called Super, which is in theaters now. Take a look at this.
I want to show you something.
What?
So what do you think? You see what I'm getting at here?
No.
Batman had Robin. The original Human Torch had Toro. The Flash had Kid Flash. I could be your kid's sidekick.
Please welcome the lovely Ellen Page, everybody. Ellen Page.
Hello, Ellen.
Hi.
Hello, dear.
I'm
good. I haven't seen you in some time. You look very nice.
Oh, well, you look awesome yourself.
Oh, stop it
as
now.
Always.
Are you all right there? See, I always feel that you're a bit, that seat's a bit big for you.
You know, I feel like most seats are, but...
Well, hang on. We got our thing here. That we
what
can,
do you...
I got this in case Tom Cruise is ever on.
Oh.
Here, hold on.
So this is...
Yeah, you put that there.
All right.
Look at that. Yeah.
Well, isn't this a treat?
Yeah. This is the big-time show business now. You can rest your feet there. People will get you a latte. Would you like some cocaine or something?
You know, I've been thinking I should do more drugs just for, romantic...
No, it's not romantic at all. That's a myth, you know.
No, I
you're a very clean living person, aren't you?
Very clean living. Very clean living.
What does that mean? That means you're not?
No, it means I'm really healthy. I eat really healthy. It's really probably annoying to people.
Really? Are you a vegan?
Well,
you eat steak, but other than that, you're a vegan, right?
I mean, you know, other than for mere survival with my own two hands in the wilderness, which I do.
Have you ever hunted and killed an animal?
With my own two hands.
With your own two hands?
Yeah, yeah.
What kind of animal would it be then? A giraffe? Do you get a lot of giraffes in Nova Scotia?
A lot of giraffes in Nova Scotia,
no, they'd be cold up there. It's too cold for them. That's why you never get giraffes in Nova Scotia. Too cold for them.
A little chilly for them, yeah.
That's where you're from, isn't it, Nova Scotia?
From Nova Scotia.
Yeah, yeah. That's in Canada, you know.
It's in eastern Canada.
Yeah. Yeah, I got a flag here somewhere.
I saw that earlier. Yeah. I saw that earlier and got excited by it.
Now that's do Canadians get aroused by their own flag?
I think they do. I think.
Because I've been up there in the summer. I'm going to get a T-shirt with a flag on.
My mom probably doesn't want me to say this, but she has a little maple leaf tattoo. She has a maple leaf tattoo.
Your mom is a
she's
tattoo?
You're
awesome!
Yeah.
Your mom is a tattoo?
She's quite the badass. So she has this little maple leaf tattoo, yeah.
Where does she,
On her back.
Ooh, tramp stamp? Is it really?
Sorry,
is it down there? That's all right. No one in Nova Scotia will mention it. There's no gossip up there, is it?
No. I mean,
you ever see a moose up there? Have you really?
Yeah.
All right.
One night I was camping, actually, and I was in the tent, middle of the night.
Do you have a house?
I do. I have an apartment up there, but
right.
I was camping, and I heard something huge outside. I was like, oh, it's a bear. I'm dead.
Yeah.
That's it. My life's done.
What kind of bears do you have up there? Kodiaks?
I guess brown bears.
Oh, right, yeah.
Black, I don't know. I've seen a bear, too.
Yeah, you...
Anyway, there was a huge moose.
A moose?
A moose outside of...
They're actually very dangerous, you know.
They
I mean,
are,
I'm joking,
and
but
and
they're dangerous.
And there was a baby, and it had a baby. So
that's even worse.
It was...
See, a moose comes up to you and gives you, a moose knuckle. You've had it. You don't know what that is, do you? Moose knuckle?
In your pants.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. Moose knuckle is kind of like an exaggerated, you know how camels have got toes? Moose have got knuckles.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, all right, see what I'm saying?
I'll use that, if that's okay.
Yeah, yeah, of course, go ahead. Now, but you're living down here now, you'll never see a moose.
Nah.
Are you living here now?
Yeah, mostly.
Yeah, is this where you got the hat?
Oh, do you like, yeah.
I do like the hat. Yeah, it's got a little bit of hipster about it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I thought I would try and spruce it up a little.
No, I think you're looking good.
This is a wig, so it just like hides.
I think I might get a wig.
Oh, yeah?
Another one.
Like for what?
No, I would like to go blonde, but CBS won't let me. They say I look even creepier. I'm like, I'm creepy anyway. It doesn't matter.
You should.
I'd like to go blonde and then dye my eyebrows one color different to another color.
I think that's a great idea.
And then I'll always look like I'm kind of a little bit closer on one side. Would you ever dye your hair?
Have I ever?
No, or have you ever?
No, I've never, and I mean, it's not something I think about. I don't think about stuff like that, I guess.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What do you think about then, Noam Chomsky?
What do I think about?
Like when you're thinking, when you're in a coffee shop listening to, Suzanne Vega records. What do you think about?
Oh, you know.
Are you interested in philosophy? Yeah, I mean, because you're quite a thinker, you're quite a reader, aren't you? You're quite a book reader.
I'd say
What kind of reading do you like to do? You like to read fiction?
I like to read fiction. I do tend to read more nonfiction, but I like fiction.
What kind of nonfiction do you read? Biographies?
I just read Patti Smith's memoir, which is, one of the best books I've ever read.
Really?
I don't know if you've read it. Just
no,
Kids.
I haven't. No, oh. She's interesting.
It's phenomenal. Yeah, she's amazing. So that was amazing. Typically, like, environmental and Bill McKibben and David Suzuki.
I have no idea what you're talking
about.
What about the, do you drive a Prius?
No.
What do you got?
I have a Mini.
A Mini?
Yeah.
A Ford Mini? Ford are advertising on the show. I don't want to look like a jerk.
Oh, I see,
Ford don't make minis. I know who makes minis. I'm not an idiot.
Yeah.
Well, I am a bit of an idiot because I'm talking quietly like they can't hear me. They can, of course, hear me. I just quite like... This is a new technique I'm using. What do you think?
It's good.
Am I scaring you? I'm a bit like a kind of To Catch a Predator guy right now.
No, I
kind of
like it.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you're unusual. You're a very unusual person. I don't know how you... I don't know how you're going to fit in L.A., I really don't. I mean, because, it's all surfing and Botox here. That's not your scene at all,
No, you'd be surprised.
When would I be surprised, then? Do you think you'll get into the surfing, then?
Well,
or Botox?
I'm really into Botox.
No way!
Yeah.
Look at you. You're as natural as a sunrise. You would never date. Don't do that now. Don't.
It's the
don't.
Botox.
No, don't do it.
People don't know this, but I'm 37.
See, from where I'm sitting, 37 doesn't look that old. Knock it off or you'll get,
I'm not saying 37's old, but it's older than 24.
You're 24?
That's what I say I am.
Ah, but you're actually 37?
But I'm 37.
Nice.
Yeah.
Have you ever worked in the circus?
No.
Oh, you're not who I thought you were then. Do you like circuses? Only if they're not animals. Right, yeah.
Yeah, one time I went to a circus in Portugal.
What?
And, yeah, I was in Portugal when I was 16. I had a half-shaved head at the time. And it was in this pretty conservative little town in Portugal, and I went to the circus, and it was amazing. And it was amazing because I couldn't understand anything. And also because it would just be like a woman would come out, and they'd be playing Michael Jackson's Thriller.
Right.
And she would have like a marionette, and it would be a skeleton. But all she would really be doing is going like this to the beat of the song.
Yeah.
For the whole song. So the skeleton would just be like... to Thriller.
Yeah.
And then came out, there was like a llama.
And it llamas are awesome. They're like sexy sheep.
And it had a... It had a monkey on its back, and the monkey was riding the llama.
The monkey was riding
the monkey was chained to the llama. So,
that's pretty.
So So the monkey was just like...
No, I'm not buying this at all.
Oh, it's 100%
true. Really? Which part of Portugal was this in then? Crazy Town?
It was like an hour outside of Lisbon.
Really? I've been to Lisbon.
Yeah.
The driving there is crazy. Did you drive around in Lisbon?
I didn't drive, but I would be in cabs, and yes, it was crazy.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Lisbon's amazing. Lisbon's
beautiful.
Yeah,
no, it's a nice town. Yeah, I like Portugal. Have you ever been to the south of Portugal?
No, I haven't.
I once drove from the south of Portugal to Africa.
What? Well,
yeah. In a stolen car. Actually, I probably shouldn't have told you that on television.
Did you steal the car?
Yeah, of course I stole the car. I don't have people steal my car. I'm not a celebrity. I steal my own cars, thank you very much indeed.
Well, you could have bought a stolen car for like,
$500. What's the point of buying a car if you're going to steal one? Have you ever stolen a car? You can tell me, it's all right.
Maybe.
Can you open a car with a
Well, it was after I saw Gone in 60 Seconds.
All right, you know, what?
I think everybody wanted to
Everybody
like,
did. That's what happened to me. It's Nick Cage that causes all the problems. That's why Jeff Peterson's here, because after Ghost Rider, I saw Ghost Rider. I want my own skeleton with his head on fire. And I had to compromise.
I don't know what those sound effects I did had anything to do with stealing a car, but...
Yeah, the...
Yeah, do you remember that?
Yeah,
It just romanticized car stealing.
Yeah, which CBS doesn't approve of that.
Right. Anyway.
We have to take a break. We'll be right back. Well, we'll stay here, and you'll stay there, but we'll play some commercials. It's a long story that you... Hi, everybody. Welcome back. We're just talking about... So you got your hat?
Yeah, I got
in Portugal,
hat.
Where you stole the car?
No. I got the hat here. I was given the hat.
Really?
Yeah.
Do people give you stuff now that you're in movies and stuff? Do they say, here, have, wear our sneakers?
I get things.
Did you get given those?
I mean, sort of. I guess so, yeah. They're like vintage. I don't know what
they're vintage. You're quite a hipster, though. Did you go up and down Melrose and spend a lot of money on the old T-shirts?
I never go shopping. Like, here, I'll give you an example.
Okay.
When I got this is embarrassing. I just don't own many things. I don't have many things in my apartment.
I don't own many things either, as you.
And I got your mug last time I was here, and it was the only mug. It was the only mug I had, and the only mug I had tea out of, and it broke. But only this part broke, so I was still using it like this.
Yeah?
And when I heard I was gonna do your show again, I was like, great, I'll get
another cup,
mug.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure I can give you something for your apartment here. Here, do you like Eddie Izzard?
Yeah.
Oh, here's a picture of him.
Oh, great.
How about koala bears? You like koala bears? Not so much?
I mean, I don't dislike koala bears.
I don't know much about them. We've got a whole bunch of stuff here. Let's see what we got. all right. How about, you need a periscope?
I definitely need that.
Oh, this is actually a marshmallow gun. No, you can't have that.
Is that is?
Do you want the picture of Liza? No, I got to keep that. How about a wig? There. A wig. A Dracula wig. Actually, you know what you should do is one of those vampire movies that all the kids are doing now. You know where the vampires have feelings and they're vegetarians and stuff?
I feel like we don't have enough about vampires going on right now.
You should do a vampire movie. I think. Oh, God, we better talk about your movie. We didn't even talk about it. I was too busy talking to Eddie.
You should go see it.
Yeah. What is the movie about?
It's about Rainn Wilson plays this character who is married to Liv Tyler.
Mm-hmm.
And she's a former drug addict, and she gets kind of sucked back into the drug world by the wonderful but rather not so nice Kevin Bacon in this film.
Right.
And
so there you are. You got your Kevin Bacon number one now. You've worked with Kevin Bacon, right?
Yeah.
Good for you.
And then what ends up happening is he wants to get his wife back, so he creates his own superhero named the Crimson Bolt, and he uses a pipe wrench as
Crimson
a weapon.
Crimson Bolt?
Crimson Bolt.
Bolt.
Crimson Bolt. Yeah. And then he meets me at a comic book store, and I become his kid sidekick named Bolty, and I'm a bit of a psychopath and a little bit of a sexual predator.
I don't think I want to see this film. Really. Kind of freaking me out. We're kind of out of time, actually. Do you want this wig or not?
Yeah, not really.
So you're passing up a free wig?
Yeah.
All right. So you're basically saying all property is theft? Oh, you didn't say that. But you implied it. All right, fine. Then you don't want anything else here. I think I've got... Hold on. I've got some cough sweets. You know what I'm saying? Do you want some candy? No. You want some candy?
I love how your candy is Halls.
Yeah, well, you know.
Hey, little girl, you want some Halls?
It's like you know me.
Oh, little girl. Hey, little girl, you have a cough. Come have some Halls.
Hey, knock it off. You're mocking me now. I have to put all my stuff back. Mouth organ or awkward pause?
Mouth organ.
Oh, you did an awkward pause and then asked for the mouth organ.
I mean, I don't care.
No, you can that's surprise fine. Me. No, that's fine. Here. All right, can you play?
No.
Okay, this is gonna be good.
All right. What do I take this?
Take it out and blow it. Oh, God.
Okay, so...
Can we get accordions or something? Because this... Yeah, it's just, you know...
I feel like I've...
Well, I can't top that. Ellen Page, everybody, we were right back. A good time for. Good night, everybody. My first guest tonight has got a new film out. Do the cat noise thing. Anyway, my first guest tonight has got a new film out.
Oh, God.
It's called To Rome With Love, which is in theatres June the 22nd. Take a look at this. Please welcome the lovely Ellen Page, everybody. Ellen Page. How lovely to see you.
You too.
You look great. You do. You've got. Yeah. I like it. It's a bit of class. It's confidence. You've got the stripes. You've got a little bit of a plaid thing and the black jacket and the hat. Boom! Fabulous.
I'm doing my best, so thank you.
You look great. Obviously, you still Canadian?
Still hanging on to
right.
the country. Yeah,
well, that's good, because I thought you were moving. You were going to move here from Canada.
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, I do sort of live here, but I love Canada. You know, they give people health care, which is nice.
I'll tell you when we're doing the election. They do, but they don't have a Stanley Cup now, do they?
We've had plenty of Stanley Cups.
Well, that's
I'm
true.
I'm super happy that LA won. And
did you go? You're a hockey fan.
I went, and it was spectacular. Yeah, I felt very
something
fortunate
else,
to be
yeah.
there. I grew up watching hockey, and
well, you're Canadian. You could probably play it.
I wish I could play it. I mean, I don't know, but I think I should just try. It's just hard because you go to a sports store in LA and you ask them about their hockey section, and they're like, "Get out of my store."
Yeah, they are. A lot of people say, "Get out of my store," and it's not even a sports store.
Yeah.
Like, I just walk in and they're like, before you even say anything, get out. Do you ever watch the Pawn Stars show on... Do you know the show I'm talking about?
No, no, I don't know this. Pond or...
Pond, no, well, Pond Stars, I think, is on Animal Planet, and it's about creatures that live in a little pond. But this is... Pawn Stars, and it's about people that have to pawn their items.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever had to pawn your items?
No, no, I haven't. But I've been to pawn shops.
Really? So you like to go and pick other people's items which have been pawned?
I just like to browse. I just like to browse.
I like to browse too, yeah. Have you ever been up to LA Zoo?
Sega Genesis, what?
Well, you can browse up at the zoo. You walk around. You're not allowed to buy anything, so you can just browse around the zoo.
Been to the
zoo. Oh, it's pretty good, except for the flamingos.
Oh.
Stink. They stink.
They do.
You don't have flamingos in Nova Scotia, do you?
I've never seen one there.
Yeah. I think if a flamingo was in Nova Scotia, it would be in the wrong place.
It'd be.
Yeah.
It'd be cold.
But you're a quite clean living person, aren't you? A vegan or something?
No, not strictly. No.
Really?
Yeah.
So you would eat a flamingo?
I don't know. I mean, no. I mean, I don't eat. I don't really eat. It's complicated.
It's not that complicated. Do you have a set?
Food politics are very complicated.
Well, okay. I understand that. Is it animals that are cute that you don't eat?
No, it has nothing.
Animals that are cute you eat.
No.
So you enjoy. So Ellen Page, you're saying you eat kittens?
Yeah. You know, not every day.
Yeah. Because you gotta work. Well, you're in the films. Oh, now this film looks nice. Now, is Alec Baldwin a ghost who appears and gives you advice?
Who knows?
Yeah. Man, you're really doing a hard sell on this thing, aren't you?
No, this is great. Go see it.
Okay, well, hey. Man, they're gonna love you.
Beautiful. Shot it in Rome. Woody Allen.
I love Rome.
Yeah.
Man, I had some tasty things happen to me in Rome.
Oh, yeah?
Like, did you have a nice time in Rome?
I had an amazing time.
Whoa, it's they got stuff there.
What are we talking about? Right? Are we talking about asparagus? Are we talking about cocaine? I don't know what you're talking about.
You know, with the right perception, you can mix them all in for the same evening. No, I'm talking about food. The food and some illicit sex. And food. Some food that I had there. The food is amazing. Did you have any of your kitten-type food when you were there?
No, but I remember being in this amazing tiny little restaurant that was family-owned and eating asparagus and it blowing my mind and being like, this is... And I love asparagus.
I know that. You brought it up a couple of times.
And it was so... It was sensational.
Mm.
Great story, Ellen. Great story.
Love it. I gotta say, you.
And that's most... why we entertain.
I love it though. You understand this show better than me or Jeff. It's like you come out here and go, I had some asparagus and it was really tasty. I mean, if that isn't deconstructing the late night genre, then I don't know what.
Crikey.
Is, Alan. That's great. Good for you. Today, what's next then? You going to another fabulous city to have asparagus? What about an asparagus tour around the world?
Maybe we should look into this.
I think it's not a bad idea. Certain cultures may prepare asparagus in different ways.
I'm sure.
For example, the native Hawaiian asparagus and spam combo.
Spamaragus.
Spamaragus. It's one of the great. And then, the French. Mm-hmm. A little bit of sauce on your asparagus.
A little bit of asparagus. I should know what asparagus is called.
In French? Well, do you speak French?
No.
A little bit. French Canadian.
My mother does, but I know.
What, when you're around?
Yeah.
So that you don't know what she's talking about? Ellen's here. Quick.
My mother.
Oh, nothing, dear. Nothing.
She was a French teacher, but she never talked. I was always my worst subject. Right?
Really, French?
Yeah.
Do you think that was a subconscious rebellion against your mother?
Probably.
Yeah.
No, I love my mom. My mom.
Well, I know you can love someone and still rebel. Your parents. I loved both my parents, but you got to rebel. It's part of human development.
Yeah. Oh, thanks, Craig.
It's all right, yeah.
Thanks so much, Craig.
Accept yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great. We have to have a commercial break.
Okay.
I like that. I find that more interesting than just someone who tell you where you're going. Welcome back, everybody. We were talking about stuff. What were we talking about?
Oh, just like cool stuff.
Yeah, cool stuff. Hey, do you ever go to you are pretty cool. Look at you sitting there with your hat on and everything. You're pretty cool. You know what you've got? You've got that Jason Schwartzman problem.
What?
Well, see, Jason's a friend of mine, and he's very, very cool. Okay. And he doesn't think he's cool at all. He's like, oh, I'm not cool. I'm like, are you kidding me?
I'm not cool.
See, you have that too. But I wonder if it's a reverse thing with cool people to make you say they're even cooler than they are. Do you guys have a little cool club that I'm not invited to?
No, I'm...
Do you go to clubs?
Clubs?
Yeah.
Like pumping it up?
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. No.
Hey, baby, I like your legs. They are nice and thick.
No.
Don't even like that?
I'm like an old person. But
you're nothing like an old person.
I was in clubs as a child.
Speaking as an old person, I feel that you're nothing like me.
I was in clubs, like clubs as a kid.
What, like stamp collecting club and that kind of thing?
Oh, I was in the chess club. I was in the Titanic club pre-movie. I was in the outdoor club.
They have a club for that?
Fencing club. I don't know. Yeah,
the fencing club that you're in, was it fighting fencing or putting up fencing around?
It was a very clever way to get free labor from children.
Right, that's a good idea. Yeah, I was part of the shoemaking and chimney sweep club.
Oh, yeah.
Right, Gavna?
Yeah.
Right, we're out of time. So, what do you fancy? Mouth organ, awkward pause, or do you want to go for the big cash prize?
Big cash.
Yeah, you do. What time is it, Sharon?
It's time for the big cash prize.
Big cash prize. $50 American in a bag with a dollar sign on it. In quarters. So you can use it for parking. Yes, exactly. That was good acting there. That was good acting.
That was good.
Now, there are three ways to win. Count them, three ways. You can either answer a question, you can guess what's in my box. Here's how that works. I imagine a box in my head. I don't know what's in it. Only Jeff knows what's in it. You try and guess what's in it. If you're right, you win the money. If you're wrong, or the new option, can you guess what Her Majesty the Queen is thinking? We've imagined a scenario where Her Majesty the Queen has been wrongly imprisoned. And we're trying to guess what she's thinking. I'm not trying to steer you.
This is what you want me to do.
Well, I'm not. I'm fond of this one because it's new. Plus, I'm very fond of her. It's her Jubilee year.
Okay, Queen's thinking.
All right, you want to guess what the Queen is thinking?
Okay, she's thinking.
Hold on.
Oh, what?
I have to set it up.
What? I don't understand.
All right, you ready?
Yeah.
What am I thinking?
Is Tawdry Bauble. Oh, I just said that.
Rocky Dingo.
Does that matter? Did I screw it up?
You swore in front of Her Majesty the Queen. I'm sorry, Your Majesty, that's just the kind of language you're going to hear in prison, unfortunately.
I'm so sorry.
However, it was what I was thinking, so you win $50. First guest tonight, very talented actress. She's Canadian, you know, Jeff.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we have a lot of Canadians on the show because we love Canadians.
We love Canadians.
Yeah.
What the hell, man?
I know. What's the weird thing about that? That email bothered me. Why don't you have Canadians on your show? She's a very talented actress. Her latest film, The East, opens this Friday. Please welcome the lovely Ellen Page, everybody else. Hey, Ellen.
Hi.
What's going on, girl?
You look sensational.
Oh, thank you.
Sorry to get all Chuck Norris on you, but no, you look good. Is that Keith Richards?
It is. It is on my shirt.
I've met Keith Richards many times.
Wow.
Have you ever met Keith?
Mm-mm.
He's nice.
Mm-hmm.
You always think that he's going to be drunk. He's not drunk.
Wow.
He's like, how you doing? All right. That's what he's like. You a big Rolling Stones fan?
Yeah.
You're saying it like.
No. Yeah, I am. Yeah.
Are you pissed? Is Canada pissed at me or something? What's going on?
Why would Canada be pissed at me?
I don't know. I get the email and then you're kind of giving me the what? What?
No, not at all. Not at all.
Okay. Are they mad at you?
No, I think, you know, they might be mad at me. Would they be mad at me?
Canadians?
I never know with them.
I know what you're saying. Scottish people are like that too. You can never quite tell if they're mad because they'll go, I'm fine. Oh, you'll be fine. It's fine. Is it like that?
No, I mean, are Canadians passive aggressive? Sometimes I wonder.
A little bit.
Yeah.
A little bit. But that's only because there's a lot of Scottish people there. I don't blame you.
No.
Personally.
I hope not.
No, I don't. No, you're fine. You're fine.
I'm fine.
that's what I was doing.
No, I mean, Canada's
you're from Nova Scotia, aren't you?
Yeah, and Nova Scotia's the best.
Nova Scotia's the New Scotland.
It is.
That's
exactly.
What it stands for in Latin.
Yeah. I took Latin for a year in school.
Did you, really?
Yeah, miserable.
Did you get that thing where they say, Cornelia est puella?
I'm horrible. All I remember is sum est est sumus istus sum. I'm not really...
That is so hot, what you just did right there. What does it mean?
Not sure. I think it's like a verb conjugation or something.
Oh, yeah.
I have lots of other great stories, so...
Tell us all about that time you... Tell us about that time you learned some Latin that you don't know what it means.
Yeah.
That's...
Yeah.
This is what talk shows are all about. And then I go, wow, really? And then I say, so you bought a house? You did?
No.
Oh, that's what people say on talk shows all the time. So you bought a house?
No.
Where did you meet your husband? So you've got a dog?
No, remember they don't.
Oh, yeah, that was bad. Yeah. I don't. It's the circle of life. It happens.
It's the circle of life.
It is. Yeah. What about a new pet? Is it time?
I mean, I would love. I'm a little crazy. Like when I see dogs, the world stops and I have to. And, you know, the voice and it's not good.
Wait,
but,
the dog's voice or your voice?
No, my voice. The shift is makes people uncomfortable, I think. But I would love to get a dog. I just feel it's hard when you're moving around all the time. You know?
Well, you want to get a monkey.
Yeah. But even, you know. My fellow Canadian, Justin Bieber, lost his monkey in Germany. I don't want to lose my monkey.
Look, it's just a thing that happens as you get older. Sooner or later, you're going to lose your monkey, you know what I mean? What about a rabbit? What about two rabbits?
You know, a rabbit bit my toe when I was 3. And
no
I
way.
Recovered, yeah.
A wild rabbit?
No, my aunt's rabbit.
What was its name?
I totally forget. And
really?
Then it bit my toe, and then I wore rain boots in the house. And then the rabbit, we were looking after the rabbit. Well, my aunt was away, and then the rabbit died in our shortly. I feel like I probably had some...
Where were you when the rabbit died?
I don't know. I was 3, so I only remember some of the details.
Are you in therapy?
I'm not going to answer that.
Well, listen, I go to therapy as often as I can.
Twice a day?
A little less than that. But I'm a great fan of it. So I'll be your therapist, and then you can tell me about the rabbit thing, and I'll sort you out.
Okay.
It'll be fine.
Thanks.
All right. Okay, I'm going to ask you a few questions. They may seem off topic, but they'll help.
Okay.
All right? Okay. So when the rabbit bit your foot,
mm-hmm.
did you think of either of your parents?
I mean, I can't remember because I was 3 years old, I feel like, so.
These memory lapses that you had when you were 3. Were they to do with alcohol? Really? Oh, right. So you went into rehab, preschool rehab? Well, you're all right now, though. There you are. And that's how therapy works, everybody. Yeah. I think if you have a breakthrough in therapy, you should be allowed to applaud. Yeah. Oh, very good.
I clap myself.
Yeah, yeah. That's good.
Well
I like
done,
that.
Ellen. Well done.
Are you quite a well-adjusted person? Do you sleep well at night?
Oh, I'm not a very good sleeper.
Really? Why? Guilty conscience?
I mean, no, I couldn't tell you.
Do you worry about things?
I might be a worrier.
Yeah, a little bit. I think you're a little bit, you have a little bit of anxiety.
Yeah.
About you, but I just thought, you know, that's...
It's sort of charming, right?
It's just adorable. Are you kidding me? Yeah. But, you know, what about, do you get enough outdoor time? This is my new thing. Outdoor time means better sleep.
Yeah.
I have trouble sleeping.
Yeah, I go on hikes. I like to roller skate and run and stuff like that.
You were in a roller skating movie, as I recall. Yeah. The roller derby one.
Yeah, Whip It.
Whip It, that's right, yeah. Do you know that Whippet's the name of a type of dog?
Yes, yeah.
They're quite good dogs as well.
The name of another, like a couple other things too.
A Devo song?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Do you like Devo?
I don't
know Devo?
I mean, I know, but, you know, I don't know, you know?
What, you mean you don't? You've never met them? Do you ever watch Yo Gabba Gabba?
Oh, yeah, it's great.
Right. Yeah. You know the guy that does the pictures, the artwork, the guy with the multicolored glasses and the shirt, and he's the singer from Devo.
Oh.
Yeah, I know. It's amazing, isn't it?
Crazy.
Yeah. I'm like, wow, this show is so out there.
It is pretty out there.
Yeah, yeah. No, I love Devo. All right, well, I tell you what, I'll take a commercial break, but you stay here. That would be revolutionary television. Like, I'll go over there and do a commercial break, which will not be broadcast, and they just leave up a picture of you sitting on your own.
Okay.
How long's a commercial break? It's not going to happen, is it? No, it's not going to happen. Why? Because you have to sell stuff. Because you are pimps. Okay, I get it.
What are we selling?
I don't know. Let's find out. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. How was it? So what were the commercials for again? Excellent products, I would imagine.
They all, those seem like trustworthy products, yeah. It's all about trust.
It is, it's all about trust. Would you ever run for office? You're a trustworthy type.
I mean, I don't think so. I don't think I'd be able to do it, be a politician.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I thought about it, and then I realized that, creepy as I am, I ain't that creepy. Yeah. Fancy finishing up with an awkward pause, then?
Yeah.
Okay.